Dear friends, welcome back! This is Nick from educates.tv and today we're going to see how to use a very interesting feature of the ESP8266 based WiMOS D1 port. We are going to load programs to the board wirelessly using the over-the-air feature it offers. Without any further delay, let's get started! A few weeks ago, we took a first look at the very promising new board, the WeMOS D1. You can watch that video by clicking in the card here. The WeMOS D1 is an ESP8266 based board which resembles the Arduino Uno board, but it offers a lot more. Huge processing power, large memory and Wi-Fi at a very low cost, less than $8. You can find a link for the board in the description of the video. Among the other features, one thing caught my eye recently. We can load programs to this board not only using the USB cable but also wirelessly. Check this out. I have loaded the standard blink program to the board. The LED turns on and off every second. I have now modified the blink program to flash the LED quicker, every 200 milliseconds. I am now going to press upload and load the new program to the board wirelessly. The board is not attached to the computer, it is powered by this power bank. We wait for a few seconds and as you can see, the new program is loaded. The LED flashes very fast. We managed to program the WeMOS D1 board wirelessly. Cool, isn't it? I think this feature is very useful as well, but now let's see how to achieve that. First of all, we have to download and install Python 2.7 in our computer. Next, we load the Arduino IDE. Please use the latest version of it. If you haven't already set up the WeMOS board in your Arduino IDE, please watch my previous tutorial in order to see how to do it. Next, we load the basic OTA program, which is available under File, Example, Arduino OTA. Next, we update the SSID and password inside the program so the board can join our Wi-Fi network. Then we select our board and we upload the program to it using the serial port and the USB cable. After that, we open the serial monitor and we can see that the board is connected to the Wi-Fi network. Only if the module is connected to the network after a couple of seconds, the ESP8266 OTA port will show up in the Arduino IDE. If the port does not show up, restart your Arduino IDE and it will appear. Now we can load any program to the board wirelessly if we set the port to the OTA port. I load the blink program and I press upload. After a few seconds, the program will be loaded to the board. That's it. But what if we want to upload a new program to the board? We can't do it anymore since the basic OTA program is not loaded anymore and the Arduino IDE can't connect to the board wirelessly. In order to update the program over and over again wirelessly, we have to enter the commands from the basic OTA program to our programs. So, I updated the blink program and it now uses the OTA commands. If we upload the program again to Arduino, we can now update it wirelessly as many times as we want, as the program will connect to the Wi-Fi network at startup. That's it. If you need to update your programs wirelessly from now on, just add a few lines of code to it and you are ready. You can find the code of the project in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, with some simple steps, we can enable the wireless update feature to our projects. Such functionality is extremely useful in case of limited or no physical access to the port. I am going to use this feature a lot in the future. I can deploy a project to its final position and then update the code and add new functionality to it without touching the project at all. It will be very easy and practical. What do you think about this feature? Do you find it useful? Please post any comments or ideas in the comment section below. Thank you! If you are new to the channel, you may not know that my day job is developing Android games and 4 months ago, I published a new game on Google Play Store. It is called Quiz of Knowledge and it is a quiz game that supports 5 languages and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, I am sure you are going to enjoy this one. If you wish, you can download it by clicking here or in a link in the description of the video. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build!